Bernard, how was the trip to the UK? Let's begin with that.
Just talk about the UK. Yeah. It's good. Well, the UK was absolutely fan-friendly. You know, the UK people are so in tune with boxing, man, that, I mean, everywhere I went, they respected me to the point where I think I lost a half a shirt. And let me tell you, I know Philly, and I know the states love me too, but I never lost half of my shirt going through a lobby or going through an arena. But literally half of my shirt, I mean, I felt like a rock star. But again, man, I'd like to say thanks to everybody out there in England who gave me not only my just due, but they gave me a highly respect, man. And, you know, I hope I signed everybody's autograph, because I damn sure was late for every place I had to go. So I told HBO, man, I couldn't get through the lobby. And they understood, but I had a great time. I had a time to reflect on the middleweight division, which has been represented by a credible guy named Triple G, who deserved to be in that position. And to actually call the fight and talk to him 3 times out there in London, and of course, the 2 times was dealing with HBO, with the fighters and announcers meeting before the weigh-in. And then we had also, after the ring fight was over, as you watched and seen, if you wasn't there, Triple G was ringside. So it was a good experience out there. I would love to go out there again.
Was that to your surprise, taking into consideration the differences you and Joe Calzaghe had when you guys fought each other? Were you surprised how they accepted you so quick? I mean,
I think that too, that's definitely one of them. And I think that they just so hardcore boxing knowledgeable fans in London. They know their sport. They know boxing. They know legends. They know guys that put it out there, whether you're from London or you're from the States. They respect craftsmanship work. And I know that I gave all in the 28 years that deed to be able to be called that. That deed is that work, put that work in. And, you know, fight fans, you don't have to be hardcore, but fight fans are hard to be tricked and hard to be fooled. And they know, we know. I think we got the most knowledgeable fans in sports. It's boxing fans. They know. They inherited it from their fathers. They inherited it from their uncles, because their uncle's going to tell them about the old, and they're going to tell them about now.
Bernard, real quick, have you fought the toughest, biggest punchers? You have one of the best IQs in the history of boxing. I wanted to know who was the most intellectual fighter that you ever faced that complicated things there inside the ring, skillful-wise.
Oscar, yeah, because even though I knocked him out, I guess, in the 8th, 9th round, he had the boxing ability, and it was a little tricky to have to figure him out. And I figured him out by keeping the fight close as I possibly can. But I couldn't do it early in the fight because that IQ was, he never let me put him in a trap. And I used that many times today, setting traps for later in the fight. That takes a patience and also takes skill, and then it takes execution. So that's why I give Oscar that. Then the second person will be Felix Trinidad.
Yeah. Bernard, you've done it all. You're the oldest champion. You've won titles in multiple divisions. What can we expect from you moving on? I mean, is there still a going away fight here planned?
Yeah, that's in the works, 70%. On our end right now, to just now making sure that the 3, which I can't name because we're still in negotiations, to close out with a hell of a 2016, but go into 2017 of the top of the year, which I turned 52. What a perfect way to say salute to the fans and thank you to the fans of a celebration that weekend in January, kick off 2017 with my last final execution. That sound like the title. Final execution. Boom.
Bernard.
Okay.
Good job, bro.
Ready?
Yeah.
Okay.
You wasn't stopping me either.
Yeah, I know.
I stuck that in.
You ready? Over here.
Yes. Made you jealous. Made you jealous.
Hey, that's good. That's
a good one, dude. I said, hold up, my man.
I love it. I love it.
That's a good one, dude.
Yeah. Y'all enjoy the fight.
Thank you.
Bernard.
Turn them off.
You ready?
Lights.
I think they're like, yeah, thank you.
Yeah, you don't want that light in there at all. You good?
Why?
Solo. She won a solo.
I'm not jealous, okay?
Hola. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
How you been? Do you want to take a picture of you? Maybe.
Yeah,
I
can tell you something.
Yo, I'll take my
picture. How fresh did you?
It's the bad part. It is lovely, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, we're doing it.
Not with the bet.
Thank you, thank you. Nice meeting
you. That's your first step.
I want to be in this.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Questions?
No, we got to go upstairs.
Oh, okay. All right.
Cool. The security won't be able to get up there.
Thank you, guys.
Tell us what you do. You sounded good. But
that's why I'm staying here. I'm not even going to. I was 45 minutes. I'm not going to. 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 I